Let's meet the Doerksen family. Donna, Steve, Susie, Bruce, and Lisa. Ready for action. Playing against the Romero family. Renee, Lori, Paul, Adrian, and Tina. On your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Coates.
Thank you very much. We've got electricity in the air here today. We've got maintenance working on it, so don't worry about that. Are you guys ready out there?
Yeah!
I think so. Two great families. We thank you for joining us at home. We've got our returning champions. They're always a lot of fun. Say hello to the Doerksen family. Hi, Steve. Your family, there's no clutch. You're always there. You never choke. You have $16,178.
Yeah!
Who did you bring to help you become champions?
Next to me is my wife, Donna.
Hi, Donna.
Hi, Ray.
My sister, Susie.
Hi, Susie.
Next to her is my cousin, Bruce.
Howdy, Bruce.
Hi, Ray.
And his wife, Lisa.
Hi. Welcome back to Family Feud.
Yeah.
We're ready. I welcome you to the show. Let's meet your opponents. Say hello to the Romero family.
Yeah.
Hello, Renee.
Hi, Ray.
How are you?
I'm fine, thanks.
Well, you are beautiful.
Thank you.
Now, you're the head of this lovely family.
Yes, sir.
Who did you bring with you?
Well, I brought my cousin, Lori.
Hi, Lori.
Hi.
And I brought my brother, Paul.
Hi, Paul.
Paul's very talented.
In what way is that?
He's a pianist.
He is a pianist?
Yes.
We have a piano here, as a matter of fact. We might give him a chance to prove his worth in just a few moments. We will see. We'll be the judge if he's talented or not. And Lori has no talents?
Oh, Lori's very intelligent.
Intelligent?
Yeah.
No way to actually prove that here today without taking an SAT test. So we'll continue on. Who else do we have?
And my beautiful sister, Adrian.
Hi, Adrian. Good to see you.
You too.
And my cousin, Tina. She's very beautiful also.
Hi,
very beautiful as well. Let me step down here to Paul real fast. Paul. She said you're a talented piano player. Now you have a pin, which is from an award, isn't it?
This is the Franz Liszt Award I won a few years ago.
Franz Liszt Award?
Yeah, as a composer. You know, everybody knows Franz Liszt. And there was a competition named after him, which I won. And they gave me this 22-karat gold pin.
Really?
For the ride.
Now that's amazing. We have a piano that CBS has furnished. Would you mind doing us just play a few bars or something with Paul?
Go ahead.
I think he would if he'd coach. Come over here, Paul. I'm going to come and watch you. Now, Paul, what are you going to play?
I'm going to play a little bit of a piece called Mozart's Turkish March.
Oh, the Turkish March.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Go ahead, Paul. Congratulations. That's excellent. Thanks. A lot of people don't know that...
Often.
People do not realize that I as well... Piano is my life, and I wrote a song many years ago. I'm going to try to play just a few bars if I could right now. I've never won the Tour de France or whatever that was you won, but... I'm prepared now. Let me just, if I could... I wrote this little song some years ago. If you know the high part, pick it up, Paul.
Okay.
I got a game show. It's called the Family Feud. We give away dough and have great families too. Boom be all a boom be all a boom. Give him a hand. Paul, good luck to you. We've got two great families. We're going to give away $5,000, and I say right now, let's play the feud. Come on, Renee. Come on, Steve. The first family.
to $300 will win the game. Get a chance to play Fast Money for the $5,000. Good luck. We asked 100 people this question, and we have the top five answers on the board. Try to find the most popular. Name something people get in and out of. Steve.
A car.
How about a car? It is number one, Ray. Back with your family. You know what is so great about this show? We have talented people like the Romero family on our show. We get the greatest, that we get the broadest scope of people. Paul is a concert pianist. Steve, what do you do?
I sell frozen bull semen for artificial insemination
of
cattle.
All right, Steve. It's always nice talking to you. I'm sorry we don't have time for a demonstration. Paul has taken that time up. Donna, name something that people get in and out of.
Bed.
Yeah.
Yes. Have you got number three?
Yes, I do.
What is that?
It's their clothes.
You're good. Yes. Let's see your clothing. Bingo. Two people said it. Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you, buddy. Got an answer?
How about an elevator?
How about an elevator? That was a great answer, and it didn't make our survey. You guys are playing good. Yeah, who are these 100 people? Hi, Lisa. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You seem happy and you're smiling and you're confident today.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what's one of the answers?
Bathtub.
Good answer.
Something that people get out of. Lisa says they do the bathtub. There it is. Five people said it. Good answer. Steve, you give me number three and you got the bank first.
I'd say shower if it's not the same as bathtub.
If it's there, that bank is yours.
Yeah.
Or the bank. Show me a shower. That was a big loud buzz, Steve, putting pressure on Donna because they're going for the steal. What do you say?
In and out of something, huh?
That's the question. Name something people get in and out of. 3 seconds. All right. She takes the third strike. It's all right. It's all right. Ramiro's, name something people get in and out of. You can steal the bank. Tina?
Debt.
Adrian.
Elevator.
An elevator, Paul.
In and out of their house.
In and out of their house, Lori.
Shoes.
Their shoes. Now, Renee, you can take those answers or go out on your own. What's number three to steal the bank?
Come on, Renee.
Do you want her to say, guys?
Come on, Renee.
Okay, I'll say house.
Their house.
In and out of their house.
Something people get in and out of. If house is there, that bank is yours. If not, the champion. Strike first. For the bank, show me house.
Come on.
The Doerksens have the bank. What should it have been?
Should have been jail.
It should have been jail?
I think it might be jail.
I don't know.
Or trouble.
Or trouble?
Yeah.
You have all these answers now. Right? Show us number three. Trouble. No one said that. You didn't go with your instincts, did you? We're coming right back, but you got to go all the way to $300 to play for $5,000. Welcome back to Family Feud. Right now, the Doerksen family, they have $84, a slight lead over the Ramiro's with zero. Let's go, Laurie. Ramiro family, facing off. This is a great question. This is the kind we all need to know. We've got the top six answers on the board. Name someone of fact or fiction who had enormous strength. Donna.
Samson?
She said Samson, and she did make it before the buzzer. Now, let me say... Samson. It's number two, but one will give you control, Lori. The question is, name someone of fact or fiction who had enormous strength. And keep in mind, myself and Gene Wood are not allowed to be as answered.
Hercules.
How about Hercules? He is the strongest man in our city. Okay, Paul. Welcome officially. Give me number three.
I would think the Incredible Hulk.
All the right. Incredible Hulk. Sure is. 18%.
Hi.
What do you got? Your hands are warm. What do you got?
Nothing.
Well, I wasn't asking you. I mean, as far as the question goes, okay. I wasn't saying you had any diseases of any type. What do you got? Nothing. I got nothing, Ray.
How about Rambo?
How about? Yeah, maybe Rambo. Hi, Tina.
Hi.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Now, we got number three sitting there. What is it?
Superman.
Whoa. Able to loop off buildings in a single bound.
Superman.
Yeah. 13 people said it. The bank is building. $66. What do you say, Renee?
Okay, can I hear the answer? I mean, the question.
The answer?
The question and the answer.
Name someone, a fact or fiction, who had enormous strength.
Okay, I'm going to have to say the Terminator, Arnold Schwarzenegger, the Terminator.
All right.
Maybe the Terminator. Show us the Terminator. Lori, if you fail to give me that answer, they're going to go for the steal. Oh. Chill out, crowd. Chill out.
Come on, Lori. What about Goliath?
Goliath.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
I always like that story, David and Goliath. Let's see if it's there. Show me. To stay alive, Goliath.
Come on.
And you got the bag.
Come on, Paul.
Tarzan.
Yeah, he was pretty strong. Yeah. For the bank, let me see Tarzan. Doerksen's. Can you steal? Name someone, a fact or fiction, who had enormous strength, Lisa.
King Kong.
King Kong. Bruce.
Mighty Mouse.
Mighty
Here I come to save the day.
Susie.
King Kong.
King Kong. Donna.
Hulk Hogan.
Hulk Hogan. Steve, there's a couple of different answers there, but what's most important, my friend, is that you give me what is behind number three.
I may be in the doghouse, but I'm going to go on my own and say Popeye.
Oh!
Popeye because the H change became very small. You guys really think it's a good answer?
Sure.
If it's there, Steve, you're a hero. And if one of their answers is and yours isn't, you're a goat. Show us for that bank, Popeye. Now, let's see if your answers were there. King Kong was the main answer that you said. Show us number three. Charles Atlas, the man who invented the road guide. All right, we're coming right back, so don't go away. There's a lot more fun after this. We are feuding. The Doerksen family has $84. Romero family, 71. We go with another face-off. Paul, up here. Let's go right now. Susie. The dollar value is doubled. We've got the top five answers on the board. Name the coldest room in the house. Paul.
Kitchen.
Let me see the kitchen.
Answer.
Not there. Any five answers gives you control, Susie.
Bathroom.
Maybe the bathroom. There you go. Thanks for the studio. Private Eye Bruce, what do you say? What is number one?
Bedroom.
Perhaps.
Good answer,
Bruce has a cold love life, the bedroom. Number one! What is that?
Living room.
Good answer.
Maybe number three is the living room. Yeah. Number four is said by eight people. Steve, what do you have?
The garage.
Your garage is in your house.
Well, it's right off the house.
Coldest room in the house, Steve says, is the garage. First strike only.
Family room.
Donna says the family room.
Good answer.
Come on. Oh.
One more miss, Susie, and they're going to go for the steal. What do you say? Keep the family alive.
The dining room.
All right.
To stay alive, let me see the dining room. There we go. You give me this answer, and you've got a big lead.
How about the basement?
Yeah.
All right.
Good answer. Good answer. Is it there? In the bag. Show me the basement. Yes, it is. The champions take the bank. $268 for the Doerksens. The Romero, 71. We go. It's another face. Come on, Adrian. Let's go, Bruce. The dollar value is triple. We've got the top four answers on the board. We asked 100 women. Name something a woman keeps beside her bed. Adrian.
Her alarm clock.
She said her alarm clock. Number one answer. Here we go. Adrian. I saw your mind shifting gears. That wasn't what you were going to say. Tina. Name something a woman keeps beside her bed.
Kleenex.
Sometimes they keep clean packs. Tissues. The other team can win, Renee, if they get the chance and steal this question. What is number three?
I would have to say diary.
Sometimes they keep their diary. First strike only.
Laurie. Hi, lovely Laurie.
Hello. What about nightshades?
The what?
The nightshades that you put over your eyes.
Okay, some women keep those
nightshades. Paul, if you fail to give me the answer and they steal, they will win the game. Give me one of the two.
I'd say she keeps her perfume.
Her perfume.
To stay alive, Paul says perfume. Doerksens, you can win the game if you can steal this question. Name something a woman keeps beside her bed, Lisa.
Slippers.
Slippers. Bruce?
Telephone.
A telephone, Susie?
Telephone.
Telephone.
A glass of water.
A glass of water. Steve, slippers. You have two answers to steal from. You can go out on your own. If you give me a correct
slippers.
Answer, you plan for $5,000. What do you say?
Slippers. I'm going to say telephone.
For the game. Show me telephone. Very good. There's one answer that we did not know. Let us see number three. Book or a magazine to do some reading. Romero family, you're awfully sweet. Thank you for being on the show. That's a nice party. Just call you a very kind. God bless you. Thanks, Steve. Bye-bye. I need two players for $5,000. Off stage. We've got the Doerksens playing Fast Money right after this. We are about to play Fast Money for $5,000. The Doerksens are the champions one more time. Steve, you know how this works. I'm going to ask you five questions. You have 15 seconds to try to give me the most popular answers that you can think of. If you and your partner pile up the 200 points or more, you're going to take home that $5,000 once again. Are you ready?
Let's do it.
You've not missed yet. For the fourth time, 15 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck. Name a country where people dress differently from us.
Spain.
A fruit sent by Fruit of the Month clubs.
Peaches.
How many hamburgers fit on your barbecue grill?
Eight.
Something in a cocktail that you can eat.
Olive.
The season you look most forward to?
Summer.
Turn around. I stumbled on the last question, but you didn't stumble on the answer. Name a country where people dress differently from us.
You said the weird dressed people of
Spain. I think they dress a lot like us, don't you?
I don't know.
Our survey said none. Okay, that's not a good start, but you're going to make up for it. A fruit sent by Fruit of the Month clubs. You said peaches. Our survey said Okay, Steve, it's not looking good, but I'm confident you're going to make up for it. How many hamburgers fit on your barbecue grill? You said? 8 burgers. Our survey said? 24. That's very good. Something in a cocktail that you can eat. You said? Olives. Our survey said? 38 up to 62. That's fine. The season you look most forward to, you said, was? Summer. And our survey said? 40. Cousin Bruce. Come on, Bruce. Right this way. How you doing, my friend?
Real good.
You need 96 points. Look straight ahead. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. If you hear this sound, it means you've duplicated his answer. I'll say try again, and you're going to give me another answer. You ready?
Ready.
It is a little more difficult, so 5 more seconds on the clock, please. 20 seconds. Revealing your partner's answers. Bring it home, Bruce. We want to see you get that money. Name a country where people dress differently from us.
Russia.
A fruit sent by Fruit of the Month clubs.
Strawberries.
How many hamburgers fit on your barbecue grill?
6.
Something in a cocktail that you can eat.
Olive.
Try again.
Cherry.
The season you look most forward to.
Spring.
Turn around, Bruce. I asked you to name a country where people dress differently from us. You said they dress differently in? Russia. Our survey said only 4. India is the number one answer, and it makes sense if you visualize it. A fruit sent by Fruit of the Month clubs, you said? Strawberries. The survey said? 0. The number one answer was oranges. How many hamburgers fit on your barbecue grill? You said? 6 burgers. Survey said? 11. 8 burgers, the number one given by your cousin. Something in a cocktail that you eat, you said? Cherry. Our survey said? 43. Cherry was the number one answer. You're 38 points away. The season you most look forward to, you said?
Spring. It comes down to this last question. If 38 people said spring, you've got $5,000. Our survey said... you got the cash. Come out here and hug it. How about that? They've got $5,000. We're coming right back. Don't go away.
Some of our departing families will receive Washington Ford's Mardi Gras flatware, light and bright to add contemporary colors to table settings, dishwasher safe, service for 12 from Washington Ford. From Chinon, Sure Grip binoculars covered with a rubberized surface for a slick look and non-slip holding. Sure Grip, the all-use binoculars from Chinon. Cherokee, stylish and comfortable apparel and shoes with a unique combination of fashion and comfort for women and girls from Cherokee. Robert Abbey's French Accent Country Collection. Beautiful hand-painted lamp, vitrified china base with antique brass burner and custom-printed fabric shade from Robert Abbey. Pledge, for generations, Pledge has kept furniture beautiful with no buildup. With Pledge, dusting can be beautiful. The rich, chocolatey taste of Hershey's chocolate milk now comes in a mix. Introducing new Hershey's chocolate milk mix. From Television City in Hollywood, this is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson Television Productions.